Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for January to March 2018. La Niña is now well established across the tropical Pacific. Climate models suggest this event will be weak and short-lived, meaning any impacts may also be weaker and shorter than many previous La Niñas. But first, let's look at recent conditions. Late spring rains helped wheat crops in parts of South Australia and Western Australia. But for some parts of southeastern Australia, heavy rain in early December made for a difficult end to the harvest. Parts of Victoria and New South Wales had 2 to 3 times their usual December rainfall in just a couple of days. The spring rain helped ease rainfall deficiencies in northern areas, but serious deficiencies remain in parts of the southeast. Sustained dry conditions in East Gippsland have seen bushfires burning in remote country. Summer heat started early in parts of southeastern Australia. Tasmania's average maximum temperature for November was nearly 4 degrees above normal, making it warmer than their typical January. December has remained warm in many areas. Northern Australia has been unusually hot, and by late December was still waiting for the monsoon to arrive. Persistent warmth and slow-moving high-pressure systems are fairly typical of a La Niña summer, especially in the south. By mid-December, heatwave conditions had spread to central and eastern Australia. Lower layer soil moisture responded quickly to December rains, particularly in the southeast. Some water storages in southeastern Australia increased slightly with this rain, but as summer continues, increased evaporation and water use means storages are not expected to fill much more. So what's driving our climate right now? La Niña is now established in the Pacific, as shown by both the ocean and atmospheric indicators we monitor. We've watched the waters off South America cool down now for several months, and the tropical Pacific Ocean has developed a typical but weak La Niña pattern. However, ocean temperatures around northern Australia and in the eastern Indian Ocean aren't as warm as in many past La Niña events, and they're forecast to stay near average. Normally, La Niña brings above average summer rainfall to much of eastern Australia. This time, impacts on our rainfall are likely to be weaker than for recent events, and our models suggest La Niña will break down in autumn. The rainfall outlook for January to March shows large parts of eastern and western Australia are more likely to have a wetter than average 3 months. Looking at stream flows, mostly low and near median flows are expected for December to February, mainly in those parts of southern Australia where soils are still relatively dry. High flows for summer are forecast for much of coastal Queensland following high spring rainfall. In terms of temperatures, days and nights are likely to remain warmer than average for parts of southeastern and southwestern Australia, but cooler than average for far eastern and western parts of the country. So in summary, 2018 is likely to start warmer than average for parts of southeastern Australia, but cooler in parts of the east and west. The rainfall outlook is above average for parts of eastern and western Australia, and low to median stream flows are expected at most locations. For more details, visit our website at bom.gov.au/climate/ahead. You can also get updates via Facebook and Twitter. Our next video will be released on Thursday, the 25th of January, 2018. Until then, have a happy and safe festive season. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Andrew Watkins.